Introducing the new LEGO Star Wars Ahsoka Tano's Duel on Peridea set number 75385. 382 pieces, includes 5 new minifigures here. This set costs $55. Here's the manual. You get your 20 insiders points. Here's the empty sticker sheet. And I'm not going to lie here. This set, after putting it together, even with the cool minifigures, does not feel like a $55 set. Let's take a look at the build itself here. So, this is a neat little play set as well as a display set, in my opinion here. So, first and foremost, there is some play features. Unfortunately, this right here, it only spins by hand. I couldn't figure out a way to spin it any other way. And these side ones, though, you see right here on the side, it spins right there. So, you can recreate some of the scenes. It's also here on the other side. As you can see, you can recreate some of the scenes from the show. And overall, it's not a bad base, in my opinion. There are quite a few stickers, as you can see. All of these right here, they are all stickers. As you go all the way around, they're all sticker. Unfortunately, there's stickers here on this plate as well, and stickers there as well. Now, the pillars on the outside, they're all stickers right here. 2 on each one, which is unfortunate. The pillars do bend down. I don't know why you would put them like that, honestly, because that's not what it looked like in the TV show, but if you wanted to, you could do that. But I do like the play features here, and overall, it's a pretty sturdy base. It gives me the same vibes as the Obi-Wan and Vader one from the Obi-Wan TV show. I forget what that set's called, but it gives me those vibes here. Taking a look at the outside here of the pillars, you get a little detail there. A little monotonous for building these. You pretty much built the same pillar 4 times. All the way around, which again was pretty monotonous, and that's like a theme with this set. But overall, I think it looks pretty nice, and I think it's going to be a good set if kids want to recreate these scenes, and a decent set for a display set. And there's also one other play feature which I found to be fun, but it's something that I probably won't ever really do aside from in this review. So if you sit Ezra right here, you can recreate his force jump. He has his lightsaber in his hand here now, but if you stand him there like this, and you can just pop him up, he doesn't fly out as far as I thought he would, but it is a neat little play feature here. You can just slam down on that and create the force jump. So that's the other play feature. And overall, it's not a bad base here. Now let's go over the minifigures, and I'll give you my final thoughts on this set as a whole, whether I think it's worth $55, but I think I already said it doesn't give me a $55 vibe for this set. First up, we have the Ahsoka minifigure here. I like the lightsabers, and they did a great job there with the clear lightsabers. And overall, this is a really, really nice minifigure. There's nice arm printing, torso, leg printing there on the feet. This is a really, really solid minifigure. It looks really, really nice. Let's take off this piece, their hair piece there, and let's see if she has a face on the back. She does have 2 faces, which I always like that. And this is a really, really nice minifigure. I think LEGO really knocked it out of the park with this one. Next up, let's take a look at Ezra Bridger here. He has his lightsaber there as well. And I think this is a good figure too. I think it's an accurate representation of his character in the TV show, the longer hair, the beard. I just think it looks really, really nice. Let's see if he has 2 face printings here. And a lot of folks, maybe if you're new to LEGO Star Wars, you don't have an Ezra minifigure. So this is the adult version of Ezra. And overall, I think it's a really nice figure, and I'm happy to add it to my collection. Let's take a look at Morgan Elsbeth. And it's worth taking a look at her saber here. I think this is a new mold here. And I know a lot of folks probably weren't too crazy about this, but I'm happy with it. I think it looks nice here. If it is a new mold, I think that LEGO did a good job here. I don't expect them to drain a ton of resources into a saber, so I think that looks pretty nice here. And overall, her figure looks nice too. I think it's a pretty good representation, again, of her character in the show from all the features here on her face, her hair. This is a cool figure. I like that LEGO did this, and I think all these figures are exclusive to the set, so getting 5 exclusive figures in one set's really nice here, and she has 2 faces here. LEGO's knocking out of the park with these minifigures in this set. The Night Trooper. Now, a lot of folks are going to say I'm crazy here. This right here, this is my favorite figure of the set. I think it looks phenomenal. I love Stormtrooper minifigures. This is just a great figure. I really, really am happy with this. I want to have at least 5 of these in my collection. I don't know how I'm going to obtain them, whether I buy them, you know, aftermarket or buy multiple of these sets. But I just think that it looks really, really nice here. I'm really, really happy to add this to my collection. As a cool face here. I think he has, nope, just one. Overall, this is a really cool figure. I'm really, really happy with this, and I have to have more than one of these in my collection before all said and done. Grand Admiral Thrawn. So as I close up this video with my final thoughts, we're going to take a look at Grand Admiral Thrawn here. I think that this set is really nice. I think it's a must-have. It doesn't feel like $55 to me, but when you're considering the 5 really awesome minifigures, I think that LEGO gets a pass for this one. I think that they went out there and said, let's give the fans Thrawn in this set, a pretty basic set, and they know that fans are starving for a new Grand Admiral Thrawn minifigure here, and they did that, and they charged us a little premium for it. And you know what? I can completely understand that. So I think you can buy this set, feel good about spending $55 if you're impatient. If you have patience, which I didn't, you can, you know, wait a little bit of time and you'll probably get the set for like $45. I think I like that this figure has 2 face printings here, and I thought it was fitting to have this figure last in my review. Now, it also makes me question, I don't have the original Thrawn minifigure. Do I still pick it up? Probably not at $100, but I think that this new figure does drive that price down just a little bit. So let me know what y'all think about my review. Let me know what you think about this set. Personally, be patient. Wait for a sale. I think that's the best thing to do here. So thank y'all for watching. Let me know what you think about my review. If y'all are new here, slap that subscribe button. If you're not new here and you watch my videos, thank you for your support, and look forward to seeing you in the next video.